I have committed no crime. I'm human, you're human. New Year's will promise her the
WFT 90.1 FM Champaign, or just WFT Champaign. And this is WEF Sessions with Slick Lisp. Welcome back. It's been, what, right at a year?
Not quite. I think we were here in October.
So, less than a year.
Fall. Yeah. We are thrilled to be back, though. It's exciting for us, always. So thanks for having us.
Oh, my! I can't take too much credit for it. Mike Ingram does the booking, but...
Also thanks to Mike.
And our other Mike, Feldman, does the sound engineering.
Absolutely.
So.
And he doesn't get enough credit, so thanks. Thank you, Mike Feldman.
Now, I would like to talk about Thursday, because I found out you guys have something going on Thursday that I should probably take into consideration when planning the rest of my week.
Yeah, definitely. We are, so this Thursday at the I4C, which is the Institute for Creativity, which is just on South Neal Street, just south of downtown. We are playing a show with Lines in the Sky and Weed Whack and Johnson, and it's an all-ages show, and it's $5 cover, but it's a cool thing. They, you know, I4C is a cool place. Like, they... they're investing in the community and trying to expose artists of all kinds, not just music. And so we're happy to play there. We actually are, that's, I think our first practice space was there, right? Our first one. And so we played there for a while, just on the weeknights.
One of those bands you mentioned sounded all exotic and Tennessean.
Yeah, Weed Whack and Johnson. I'm not going to lie, I don't know a whole lot about them, but I'm excited to see them. And actually, Lines in the Sky is pretty exciting. Give them a listen if you haven't yet. So it should be a good time. So come on out.
I just may.
good.
Straight. We have a great studio audience, and I have to have my back to them to talk. So
yes.
I'm.
How about
I'm,
it, studio audience?
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
One thing before we go on, would you guys mind reintroducing yourselves just so everybody at home knows who's here tonight?
Yeah, we're called Slick Lisp, and we are from Champaign. And my name is Scott Thomas. I'm the singer. And Jeremy Bosch on lead guitar, Eric Bartel on bass, and Ian Shaw on the drums. It's probably just easier for me to say their names.
You realize if you make the big time, nobody's going to believe that's your real name.
What's that? Slick Lisp?
No,
Scott Thomas.
Scott Thomas.
Oh, well.
It sounds like your real name should be Bernie Liederkranz
or
something.
Right, right, right.
Scott Thomas was the radio-friendly version.
Yeah, I thought you were going to say because I have two first names. Like, I've been getting that my whole life. You can't trust a man with two first names, Scott Thomas.
I've never heard that before.
I don't know. I never heard it either until I was born with two first names. So.
Well, what do you have for us next?
Our next song is going to be called Ride Fall Down. And it goes like this.
Lay my head down on a cold bed. Lay my head down, admit it's over. Headlight shadow on my dimmer they spin. Wish I had a place to go to. I don't wanna find another. I don't wanna get up out of my head. Lay my head down on a cold bed. Lay my head down, admit it's gone. Coming around, I'm out of my head, I can't figure out. I shed the covers and I wash my skin. Coming around, think I'll go out. Making eyes and a girl in all red. Guessing I'm onto something. I don't want to think it over. skipping my step, breathing out so I can breathe out. She's coming around. I'm out of my head. I can't figure out how I waited. I'm not messing around.
Thank you. Hey, Mike, could I get some vocals back in my monitor? This next song is called Nosedive, and it's about our guy Jeremy here's harrowing experience on an airplane flight.
You don't want to know the real truth.
It goes something like this. Thank you so much.
I'm guessing it's close enough to 10:30 to go ahead and talk, since the band is standing around not playing.
Sure.
So, this is WEFT Sessions on WEFT Champaign 90.1 FM, and we have Slick Lisp back. And I'm sort of amused because when you guys played record wasn't record store day, but when you played the record store, I said you should come back on, but you were already booked. So
yeah, this is a couple weeks ago. So yeah, it was excellent timing.
We'll say I knew that all along. It's a good segue.
We played a nice little show with the Underwerewolves, who are also a past performer here, and so that was a good time. It was fun, and like I said, we're happy to be back. And this next song is going to be called Eyes. We'll be right back. This next song is, we didn't play this one last time because we didn't write it yet, but it's a song called 40 Winks, and goes out to our girl, Jess.
Pride has circled all around me. Stress seems to weigh the key. They all wanna know my play, but I am not about to say. Every night I watch the praying, stand inside the moonlight shade. I'm so tired of looking on, show the fang strike at dawn. Takes a man out of me like I'm 11 years old. Drinking now she seems interesting. Life like I'm on a roll. That's called to make mistakes. Better throw it on the wall and see what sticks. I caught her looking at me around
Thank you, thank you. That song, that's a song called Unicorn, and that is the title song off of our EP, which we recorded last summer. Speaking of, again, we're called Slick Lisp, and we've got many social media forums, so find us. If you like what you hear, find us, like us, follow us, whatever. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all of the above, you know. So, but you can find that one in an EP from last summer. And our plans here in the upcoming future are to get back in the studio and record a few more songs, so stick around. But this next song is going to be called, it's also off that EP, and it's going to be called Instant Gratification. And so this next song is our newest song. And, it's called Kismet, and it goes like, it's our newest and slowest of songs, so. Ridiculous and humor. So we are down to our last two songs here. Thanks for listening. Thanks for tuning in. Anybody out there on the internet, whoever, on the radio, appreciate it. Appreciate you guys listening. And we'll do one more, and then we'll have Todd tuck us in.
speculate is a futile job. Whatever's next, occupies your mind. Maybe yours are no way, not mine. Keep running, it's coming. I would rest if I were you. Save your breath for something new.
Again, to our studio audience.
You may have started a new tradition. I don't think in all the years I've been hosting the show anybody's referred to this part of the show as getting tucked in. So, and I would second that. It's great having a good studio audience, and it's great having a band that brings out a great studio audience. So thank you for that. Could we plug any shows you have booked right now? Certainly the one this week, but I think we have a little time. So
yes, definitely. We are playing so this Thursday, July 28th. Institute for Creativity, or I4C. I think it's a 9 o'clock start, $5 cover, and then we got a little bit of a break, and we come back August 25th at Cowboy Monkey with a band from Spain called Holly Brandy. So that's coming up here in about a month, I guess.
Do you know what part of Spain?
No, I don't. I'm remiss to say. But
one reason I ask is depending where. Spain's got this weird thing where they're very proud of their city, but being region is a little more popular.
Oh yeah, for sure.
So right. Like you actually are better off speaking English in Barcelona than Spanish, because they don't want to speak Spanish there. And I lived in Spain long enough that I
did you?
It just gets me curious. It was for school. It wasn't like I was I didn't ever stop being an American citizen or anything.
Still there though. It's pretty cool.
Oh yeah, yeah. I would love to go back, but I gather they're not having a very good time there right now.
Yeah,
so.
Well, it seems like the economy's maybe bouncing back. I don't know, but
fingers crossed, because. Yeah. Anyway, so you got that.
Yep. Out of the way.
Thursday is?
July the 28th.
July 28th and August 25th.
August 25th, right, which so I believe is a Thursday. Yeah.
Are those the only two for now?
That's it for now, yeah. We are, like I said earlier, we are making plans to get back in the studio here soon, so that's kind of been one of our, you know, main focus.
Do you know where you want to record?
Well, that's one of the things we're, you know, we're trying to figure out what the best, you know, what we can do and maybe what's going to make us be a better band, you know? So we're working on it.
These guys probably have some, I don't know, friendly advice.
Yeah?
Well, I mean...
Oh, right.
If they're following you here, surely right. They have preferences.
Right.
So
definitely. Oh, yeah, we bounce ideas off them. What do you guys like? What do you not like? All that stuff.
I did, just so people learn your name and recognize it when they see it. Are there any stories relating to it that are interesting enough to tell on air?
That's a funny story, because there are absolutely zero stories. We literally, so most of the time, you know, we kind of communicate via text message and just, you know, setting up practice plans or whatever, you know, just all kinds of stuff. And, man, we must have bounced, 4 days of approximately 200 band name ideas a day. And then I don't know why. I think Eric and Jeremy came up with it between a conglomeration of the two, right? Combining two ideas. And it was the first one that all four of us said, yeah, I can live with that. I don't know what it means, but, it, you know, I guess it's memorable. And we didn't give it much thought. And then, like, literally that day, I think we made a Facebook page and an email account or something. And we're like, well, here we go.
I think the band names that stick are generally the ones that spur of the moment.
Yeah, right.
Because if I had a nickel for every band that said, well, that isn't one we ever expected to stick, then
right.
You know, then they go on defend. I mean, like the you remember the Surfers from the 90s had like a different name every show. And then they got stuck with one that they actually couldn't say on the radio at one point. So and of course the Goo Goo Dolls don't like discussing their name because it's embarrassing.
Yeah, I think one of our main objectives was just that if you could type it into Google, that we would be the only thing that came up. Like if you call yourself, you know, the T-shirts or the George Washingtons or something, like you're going to find a million results, right? So it was something that if you Google it, you'll find us, and it looks all right on a T-shirt or something, and you know that was
that's smart. You know, there was a band here about 25 years ago called Area, and they were just impossible to look up. So anyway, I said before the show, if you didn't get to anything this hour and you think of it at you know, during the last song, you're welcome to stick your heads in the booth, say goodbye, you know, while you're loading out. So I will just tell everybody to stay tuned for some new Sleepy Kitty and a whole bunch from 1929. And, of course, one more song, the encore from Slick Lisp. They're playing this Thursday. Say hi if you're there. And this is WFT Champagne. Yes. Thanks.
And thank you for listening. Can't concentrate. Power.